green gardens in Laventai. Soldiers only know the street, where the mud is churned and splashed about by battle-wending feet. And yet beside one stricken house there is a glimpse of grass. Look for it when you pass. Beyond the church whose pitted spire seems balanced on a strand of swaying stone and tottering brick, two roofless ruins stand. And here, behind the wreckage, where the back wall should have been, we found a garden green. The grass was never trodden on. The little path of gravel was overgrown with celandine. No other folk did travel along its weedy surface but the nimble-footed mouse running from house to house. So all among the vivid blades of soft and tender grass we lay, nor heard the limber wheels that pass and ever pass. In noise, continuity, until their very rattle seems in itself a battle. At length we rose up from this ease of tranquil, happy mind, and searched the garden's little length, a fresh pleasaunce to find. And there some yellow daffodils and jasmine hanging high did rest the tired eye. The fairest and most fragrant of the many sweets we found was a little bush of daphne flower upon a grassy mound. And so thick were the blossoms set, and so divine the scent, that we were well content. Hungry for spring, I bent my head. The perfume fanned my face, and all my soul was dancing in that lovely little place. Dancing with a measured step from wrecked and shattered towns, away upon the downs. I saw green banks of daffodil, slim poplars in the breeze, great tan-brown hares in gusty march a-courting on the leas, and meadows with their glittering streams and silver scurrying dace. Home, what a perfect place!